Hey everybody, it's Amanda, and I thought I would do a little bit of a different video. My friend Melissa over at House Plaid Fuzz, she did a video on Instagram where she was talking about some of the books that she'd been reading lately and her thoughts on them, and I really enjoyed it because I love books and I read a lot. And so I'm here at the library, and before I take my books back that I got out, I wanted to talk to you about a couple of the books that I got and my thoughts on them, you know, maybe just in case you were thinking about reading them. So I'm going to show you a few of these and just let you know what I think. So the first one that I got was one I was really excited about, Homebody by Joanna Gaines. And this book, it says, a guide to creating spaces you never want to leave. And so it was supposed to be her big, like, interior design training book. And I got to be honest with you, I need some help in this area. So I was really excited to read this book and maybe get some advice and helpful hints to maybe do my interior design a lot better. But anyway, so this book, I got to be honest with you, I was really hoping that it would be more instructional in nature. And I think that she shares her heart about interior design, and there's a lot of pictures and a lot of ideas, but it's not as instructional as I was hoping it would be, if that makes any sense. I don't want to be critical about Joanna's book. I think it's a beautiful book, and I think there's a lot to glean from it. But if you're looking, because I was looking thinking that it was going to be like almost like a course. Do you know what I mean? And it's not that. It's not that. It's just some ideas with some pictures and kind of some things to lead you in a good direction. Like I said, I think it cheers her heart about interior design, but it's not going to teach you to make your house like Joanna's houses. I'm sorry, it's not. At least it's not going to do it for me. So maybe it's enough for you, but it wasn't enough for me. Alas, I don't think my house is going to look like Joanna Gaines. But it's a very pretty book, and it's a very nice book, and I appreciate, just because I like Joanna Gaines, I like reading what she has to say, because it's just one of those ways that you feel connected to her in a strange way, not creepy. You know what I'm saying. So anyway, the next book that I want to share with you is this one. It's called The Art of Fermentation by Sandor Alex Katz. And it says, an in-depth exploration of essential concepts and processes from around the world with practical information on fermenting vegetables, fruits, grains, milk, beans, meat, and more. So I'm really interested in learning more about fermentation. And this book actually is super detailed. Like, this one is almost too detailed. Like, I couldn't even go into all of the different things that it goes into here. And I'm just sitting in the parking lot and there are people around me. But anyway, it's really a lot of great information, in that I don't really know much about fermentation beyond like kimchi, sauerkraut, maybe some sourdough. And there's a lot more to it than I realized. So it actually took me a while to go through this, and I still didn't even get through the entire thing in the time that it was, had to go back to the library. But I really like this book, and I think this is one of the books that I'd actually like to purchase and have in my house as a reference. So this is a great one if you want to check this out. And then the last one that I want to mention to you is this one. It's called American Food Writing. I don't know if you can see that there. And it says, an anthology with classic recipes, edited by Molly O'Neill. This book, I almost grabbed it, just, I don't know why I grabbed it. I didn't expect much from it, because I mean, there's really not much information on the cover or on the back. But I loved this book. I do want to buy this book. I actually looked it up on eBay because I want to get this book. And it's got a lot of, it does have classic recipes, including a recipe. It said Thomas Jefferson was the first American to write a recipe for ice cream. And so I just thought, it has that recipe in here. It's got a lot of really old recipes and a lot of information behind the recipes, which is helpful to me, because I think, just as someone who is constantly looking at recipes and food and wanting to know the stories behind it, I think that a lot of those stories and things behind it help to give you information about how the recipes were created. My daughter is over here next to me on her phone giggling. There she is. But she loves hearing me talk about books. But anyway, I really like this book. And it actually goes up through modern times too. Even to like Michael Pollan has some books or some kind of something in here. But there's all kinds of things from the beginning of American history to now. And if you're interested in reading about old recipes and reading the stories behind them and seeing the connections between history and what we eat, I mean, I think this is a really, really great book. I highly recommend this one. So anyway, those are just three of the books that I've checked out. I'm getting ready to go in the library and get some more. So let me know if you want to hear more book reviews. I will link in the description box an Amazon affiliate link to all of these books. If you want to go get them on Amazon, you can. But maybe you can find them in your library and just get them for free like I did, because that's obviously the best way to do that. I'm going to run in here and see if I can find some other things. And it's gonna be a good day. I loved finding things to read. So anyway, you guys have a great day. Thanks for hanging out with me, and we'll see you next time. Bye.
Hey, thanks for watching. I'm really glad you came to visit us here at the Fermentation home. Make sure if you enjoyed this video that you click the like button, and also click subscribe right below me for more videos coming into your inbox all the time. And also, if you enjoy social media, we've got links up at the top here for Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest, all the other fun things. And check out thefundamentalhome.com for more information about what we're doing all the time and how we do it, because there's way more details there. And here over to the right, we have some videos that I recommend. So thanks again for coming by, and we'll see you next time. Bye!